When a medical student gets a cadaver, it really is a rite of passage.
When we first began, the thought was to use the virtual cadavers. But since we moved here about a year ago, we have been planning to incorporate cadaver to complement our anatomy curriculum.
Being able to be the first students here at the Kirk Kerkorian School of Medicine with cadavers is an amazing experience. Being able to be the first student class to go in, I think is really important because we're going to be able to pioneer that for future students as well.
This will be my first experience ever working with a human cadaver. I'm excited. I'm a little bit nervous just because I don't know how I'm going to react to seeing something in person for the first time.
It's a weird experience, but then you very quickly get to realize that it's lucky that we get to use these people, and we're very grateful to them for donating their bodies to science so that we can learn it.
My first time with the cadaver, that experience was definitely a little bit daunting. I had never seen something like that before, but over time, I learned to appreciate it as we dove deeper throughout the entire body.
The plastinated specimens are primarily used for looking and observing and learning from. The actual donor cadavers are going to be used for actual dissections. So students come in and practice doing dissections to make structures visible for the first year students to learn from. And then eventually we will be able to perform certain procedures on them before we return the bodies.
I think when you have a cadaver, you realize the sanctity of life. I also think it gives you an opportunity to learn through touching, through sensation, which activates different pathways in the brain and makes remembering material that much more easy.
I feel really proud and grateful to be able to deal with both different types of cadavers. I think it really helps to build us to become better doctors.